The middle of nowhere has been keeping a secret. And we're off to find out what it is and how it can change Africa.
South Africa has one of the highest internet penetration rates on the continent. But despite that, people who live in remote places like this say they don't use the internet. Two of the biggest barriers, according to research, affordability and accessibility.
Mankosi is made up of 12 villages, home to over 6,000 people. And until late last year, there was no electricity here. Running water is still a luxury. But they have a cheap and stable wifi network. They built and registered their own internet service provider.
Molweni, mama.
Molweni, molweni, mntanam.
Ninjani?
Khona ninjani?
Mama, I'm wondering if I could buy a voucher.
Yeah, you can. Can buy a voucher.
Really? How much does it cost?
25 rand.
25?
Only 25 rand.
Okay.
It lasts a whole month.
A whole month?
Mama Sikau is one of the elders who convinced other villagers that the internet would bring development here. She's one of a handful who sell vouchers that gives residents and visitors uncapped Wi-Fi for under $2 a month.
So did you know what Wi-Fi was before it came?
No, we didn't know. We didn't know anything about Wi-Fi.
And now
it is when it came and connected, then we see there is something that gives better life. And at school, people do their homeworks, everything. Even when I didn't got TV, I can see news, Zalo, everything.
South Africa's data prices are still among the most expensive on the continent. According to the latest research out of Africa's six leading economies, 1 gigabyte of data would cost you 7 times more here than it would in Egypt. That's 3 times more expensive than in Kenya, Nigeria, and Ghana.
So why is Mankosi Wi-Fi so cheap? 7 years ago, researchers from the University of the Western Cape, with the help of the community, built a mesh network here. It's a cheap, low-energy system using scattered node devices, rather than a central mast or beacon that's used by traditional telecoms networks. These nodes communicate with each other. An important feature is that it's solar-powered.
So we're at the home of one of the headmen of the villages that make up Mankosi. This is known as Ngobo. And once a month, community members meet here as part of the cooperative.
It functions much like a business. And this is the board meeting, except it's owned, operated and maintained by villagers. They collect the money they make from selling Wi-Fi vouchers. This is funneled into community projects. The name of the network is Zenzeleni. It means do it yourself. And 33-year-old Zuku Chichi is the embodiment of that slogan. Previously unemployed and unskilled, he's now the resident technician.
Looks like there's a problem with our connection here.
The village built this mast themselves at a fraction of what telecommunications companies quoted.
At the beginning, I thought when this dream came to our village, you know, I thought it's impossible, you know. We can't make a network because we never started a network. It's impossible, you know. And then as the time goes, I saw, no, this is going to be real. That's why I put in my effort, trying to learn everything according technically. So yeah, now my dream come through now. So I like to prove people wrong. When I see the kids using the internet, they know that their internet they are using was made by the people from they know, from here in the same village. So it's like I'm a god to them.
We want to know where they buy their internet. We want to know what they're doing with the internet. We want to use
While Zuko maintains the infrastructure, others try to understand how the internet is used. These researchers are doing a survey. Professor William Tucker oversees the project.
We're interested in seeing the different usage patterns because We want to see, learn what are the barriers to people adopting the technology, and what are the things that they're actually using it for.
One of the biggest barriers is access to devices that support the network.
We are searching for a cause of globalization.
At this local school, students make use of smartphones.
Yeah, it's not the internet app. So, I was born in the internet.
We're about 60 kilometers from Mankosi in an area called Zitulele, and this village is the latest one to get online.
How difficult is it to balance the traditional way of life with bringing advancement in the form of Wi-Fi or this network?
Yeah, it's not easy. Yeah, but we are kwaze kukwenzeka londo. Nathi singabantu futhi siyazibona izinto ezenzekayo siyayibona uba kuqhubeka ndoni so kuyakwazeka ukwenzeka lonto uzidibanise into ezimbini xa ufuna isizwe sakho sikhule sibe sisizwe esiqhakazileyo sibe sisizwe sizokhupha abantwana abanekamva liqaqambileyo.
Retaining traditional and community values and combining it with advanced technology. And to me, that's what a rural community network is. It's like this meeting of two worlds. The youth will come and do things that we can't even think of. I think it's amazing.
Community networks like this one could be a way to connect Africa to the global village. Driven by the innovation and energy of the youth, the people of Mankosi say this is just the start for Zenzeleni.
This is my dream now. It is inside my heart now. I can't run from this now anymore.